The Judy Garland Show, show number 6.
Mysterious. You work, you save, you worry so, but you can't take your go when you go, go, go. Keep repeating, it's the berries, the strongest oak must fall. The sweet things in life to you were just loan, so how can you lose what you never own? Life is just a bowl of cherries, so live and laugh at it all. Just a bowl of cherries, and here's June Allyson, and she's a peach. Life is just a bowl of cherries, and Steve Lawrence is the apple of my eye. And he's the berries. Gee, what a wonderful pair.
Hey, you made it funny. Don't forget to tell them Jerry is waiting for his curtain.
Jerry Van Dyke! Life is just a bowl of cherries, so live it.
Television City in Hollywood, the Judy Garland Show, with tonight's guests, Steve Lawrence and June Allyson, brought to you by Contact, the capsule with the tiny time pills. Contact for all day, all night relief from head cold congestion.
Thank you very, very much. You know, of all the songs that I've
sung about... Okay, kid, let's talk.
Talk?
Yeah, talk. It says right here in the rundown, before Judy's number, Judy, Jerry, ad-lib, talk. Let's talk.
But we didn't rehearse any ad-lib.
You don't rehearse ad-lib. Talk, kid. It's ad-lib. Come on.
Oh, yeah. Well, all right, fine. You go ahead and ad-lib.
All right. It's your show. You go first.
Jerry, why can't I just talk? I mean, it'll sing. I
can't
ruin
sing,
that.
Sing, kid. This is television.
I don't know how to talk about it.
Yeah, but it's TV. You gotta talk.
Yeah?
That's how people get to know what you're like.
Hmm.
You gotta talk. Just from what you're seeing right now, they know a little something about you out there.
Well, I know they're getting to know that I'm not much of a talker.
Good! Good! That's right. Stick with me, I'll make you a TV star, kid.
You keep calling me kid. Do you know how old I am?
No, how old?
I'm old enough to like your calling me a kid.
Oh, look, baby.
That's even better. That's better.
Listen, I know you've been on a stage and you made a lot of movies, honey, but this is TV.
Yeah.
Television. BTSB, big time showbiz.
Mm.
You gotta listen to me, boy. With television, it's talking. You ever see my brother's show?
Yeah.
He walks in the living room and he falls over that hassock, my brother Dick Van Dyke.
Yeah,
huh?
Not on the show.
I made him what he is today. Well, that's enough. This, we're supposed to be talking. Now, come on, talk.
But I don't know. What are we gonna talk about, Jerry?
Kid, you gotta talk on television. You just gotta talk. That's the way they get to know the little things about you out there.
You mean just plain things?
Sure, sure. That's okay. How they know.
All right, well, I'll tell them.
All right.
Okay, well, I look terrible without makeup. And I'm very emotional. And I snore in my sleep. And I lost my makeup.
And you talk too much. Audience, those kind of things. Oh, boy, now we got to win him back. Get the sing over the rainbow.
Wait a minute,
over the rainbow. Good. You got to talk. I just tell you, you got to talk before you sing.
Jerry, how long are we supposed to just stand here doing this?
About a minute and a half.
Oh. Well, it's been nice talking to you.
Go get him, kid. I don't know how she got this far.
It seems like happiness is just a thing called Joe. He's got a smile that makes lilacs want to grow. He's got a way that makes the angels heave a sigh when they know little Joe's passing by. Sometimes the cabin's gloomy and the table's bare, but then he'll kiss me, and it's Christmas everywhere. Troubles fly away, and life is easy go. Does he love me good? That's all I need to know. Seems like happiness is just a thing called joy. But then he'll kiss me, and it's Christmas everywhere. Troubles fly away, and life is easy go. Does he love me good? That's all I need to know. Seems like happiness is just a thing called Joe. Little Joe, my little Joe, little Joe.
Under my skin, I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart, you're really a part of me. I've got you under my skin. I've tried so not to give in. I said to myself, this affair never will go so well. But why should I resist when, baby, I know so well I've got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, spite of a warning voice that comes in the night and repeats in my ear, don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. But each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. I've got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice comes in the night and repeats in my ear, don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. But each time I do, the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. I've got you. I've got you. I've got you. I've got you. Yes, I've got you. Under my skin. So lucky to be the one you run to see in the evening when the day is through. I only know what I know. These passing years will show you've kept my love so young, so new, and time after time. Yes, I'm lucky, I'm lucky, 'cause I'm loving you.
Anything, it doesn't make any difference. He's your guest, make him feel at home. Now.
Hi, Judy.
Let's talk!
Why is she hollering at me? I'm her guest. I see that Jerry finally got through to you with the advice, eh?
Yeah.
I bet he told you to talk with your guest, and walk with your guest, sing with your guest, and dance with your guest.
Right.
And laugh with your guest, and make him feel at home. Right?
That's right, that's right. He told me to chat with my guest, do that with my guest, and above all, never to sing flat with my guest, and oh, so much more. But I suppose you've been through this once or twice before.
Once or twice?
I've done 3,1437.6 appearances. I got a lifetime Nielsen rating of 58 or more. Hey, Judy, have I been through this before?
You've done Steve Allen.
And Johnny Carson.
And Jack Paar.
And there's Gary Moore. And there's...
Just a minute, Steve. I think you need a bit of rest. So open your collar and loosen your tie.
You mean to tell me it's not do or die?
Why don't you really relax, Abby, my guess?
All right. You mean I don't have to say all that cliched television jazz like, Judy, how good to see you, when everybody knows that we've been rehearsing together all week?
Yes, of course. Just be honest. Just tell the truth. Just tell the truth.
Good. Judy, it's good to see you. Why weren't you at rehearsals all week, Bob? I've been looking for you. They've been paging you. They've been bringing packages. I've been signing your name all week. I don't know. You mean I could really have this kind of freedom, huh?
Of course.
Sure, I just want to double check. You mean I can say things like, Judy, you used to be so fat.
Be my guest. Stay, Steve. You didn't look like this before. How'd you get like that?
Be nice now. We're on television. I'm your guest. I'm your guest.
That's right, yes.
Hey, and I think I'd like to say my dressing room's too small. And this lighting, to say the least, it's not the best.
Let's see. The lighting room's bad. The dressing room's small. Are you sure that's not at all? That's not everything you want to say, is it?
Oh, I got a whole list here. I got.
Wait a minute, Steve. I said be my guest, not my pest.
I'm only trying to be honest. Yeah. And may I add, my music's much too loud.
Be my guest.
That's the biggest, the loudest band in all the world. Kidding, 'cause seriously, I was so delighted when you invited me. I really think I would have done this show for free.
Oh, well, be my guest, by all means.
Now, wait,
be
wait, my guest. Wait a minute. I'm just moving around.
He's done 3,1437.6 appearances.
But to tell the truth, I'm not depressed. 'Cause when you're the hostess, I like it fine.
Believe me, Stephen, the pleasure's mine.
Here comes the commercial, will you get off the line?
I guess we better listen to him. He's got a hit brother.
Yeah, but we... What about a Stephen Edie ending, huh?
Okay.
Okay.
Which one do you want to be?
Oh.
No, I'm just kidding. Be my guest.
All right, fine.
Be my guest!
And now, I'd like to present my friend. Join the group instead of being a party boot. Obligato, pizzicato, gallivardo. It's the craziest when you do with a doodling song. 2, 3, 4. I like it so much, I'll doodle some more. A little softer, pericomo. Even softer, pianissimo. Say you love me with a doodling song. B, C, D. Doodle-a-doo-doo. Say you really love me. Say you love me true. Say you love me. Please believe me when you do. And that makes two. Here we go now. Bet your boodle. Like the apples in a strudel. When you're with a doodle in song, what you call a real ball.
Proud of you. I didn't survive.
Yeah. Well, you know, I did miss one note.
I know, but I miss notes all the time.
Well, I think I looked at the wrong camera.
That's all right. I can't ever find the right camera. It's very confusing.
Now, well, did you notice when I came out, I was on the wrong mark?
I overshoot my mark every week. Don't worry about it. You know something? For a couple of people who overshoot their mark and can't find the notes and look at the wrong camera, we make an awful lot of money.
You don't say anything, and I won't say anything.
Right, right.
Hey! Hey, what are you two doing?
I'm talking the way you tell me to talk.
You're not supposed to be talking now. You're supposed to be singing a song, and there's a commercial coming out.
Well, he told me to talk. You told me to talk, you know. He did. I know. So the people get to know me.
Oh, they want to know about you. Let them read it in a fan magazine. Write them a letter. You got to sing a song. Now you've got a minute and a half to do a two-minute song in.
Oh.
Come on. Go get them, kids. These silent film stars, huh?
He's got a hit, brother.
All right, we have a 2 minute song. And 1 minute
I think,
and a half.
I don't know how we're going to do it.
Minute 15!
We better get started, right. I think. Just relax.
Picture you upon my knee, a tea for you, and two for tea. Tea for you, and you for me, Lord.
1 minute.
Oh, dear. Well, here we go.
Nobody near us to see us or hear us, or friends or relations of weekend vacation. And we only have an old day that we own a telephone, dear.
20 seconds.
Day will break and you will awaken. Doop 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 doop.
10 seconds.
It's either for me.
5 seconds.
We raise that
day for
you.
3, 2, 1.
Wait a minute!
The first half of the Judy Garland Show has been brought to you by Menley and James, makers of Contact for all day, all night relief from head cold congestion. The second half of the Judy Garland Show is brought to you by General Mills, home of Betty Crocker products. New gold medal Wonder Flower, and the Big G Goodness Cereals.
About how they pitted us against each other.
Yeah, I know.
It was very sad.
Yeah, it was terrible. Terrible. We're talking about Metro.
That's Metro Goldwyn Mayer.
And we were both sort of raised there.
Yeah, I'm very young. I don't care what Jerry says. We were very young.
Then. Forget it now. She was coming out from New York. She had just done Best Foot Forward. And she was coming out and to take my place. You know, when I really failed, because they said, I hadn't even failed yet the first time. They said, well, we've got this young girl, you know, best foot forward, June Allyson, and she's coming from New York, and she's better than you'll ever dream to be. She's so good. You better behave yourself, because she's going to take it. And she's got Margaret Sullivan's voice. She's got everything. And look out, kid. Just behave yourself.
Yeah, what they said, well, it was terrible. What? They said, you know, you may get a chance if Judy doesn't want to do the picture. We're not sure. You can't sing as well. You can't do anything as well. But you may get a chance.
They really didn't want us to like each other at all.
I hated
you. There's a gnat. Believe me, there's a gnat.
Way.
What she used to do... But you realize, and we'd walk down the street toward each other, and I'd be thinking, who is this blonde girl who's come out? And she'd jump into little doorways and run up the stairs.
Yeah, I said, there's Judy Garland.
Then I found her waiting in the rain at a bus stop.
Yeah.
At a bus stop in front of Metro at a gate that hadn't been used for years, you know. And
but
it was in the rain,
it.
And she was standing all alone. And even though you were going to take my place, and high time you did. And you did later, as I remember. Yeah. Just, you know, and it looked bad for all of us. It really did. So I stopped the car and said, where are you going? And she said, home. And I said, where do you live? And she said, I don't know. And I said, well, get in the car. I'll drive you. So, I think you had to take 5 transfers before you got there.
Yeah, I did. A lot of buses. I hate it.
Now then.
Sir?
No.
I mean, don't you? I think you ought to do your impression of me.
How do I do that?
I don't know. You do it.
Okay. Well, I can't really do it correctly.
That's fine.
Tell about the dramatic coach at MGM. Who's
oh, had a marvelous dramatic coach.
Yeah.
She came to me and she said, you have a lovely smile, June. There's only one thing wrong. When you smile, we can't see your eyes. So I practiced smiling with my eyes open. I haven't ever closed them since. No, I don't want to.
Nobody
see
ever wants everybody just said you say tell me you had laryngitis. You told me you had laryngitis. And you told me this for 3 days of rehearsal, and I finally got it. You sound like a bell.
Oh, I still have it.
Yes. Well now let's see.
Do me.
Oh, I know. One thing I really have to talk to you about.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, royal wedding. Well, you don't know it because we're both canceled. But the thing is, I got a vacation.
Yes, I
finally got a vacation from Metro. I'd done about 182 pictures. And they said, you can have 3 weeks off. So I went to Carmel and to play some golf. And I was there for 3 weeks since I just finished Easter Parade with Fred Astaire. You went into royal wedding with Fred Astaire. They called me and said, get back here. She's pregnant, and you got to take her place. And I said, well, I don't want it. So I went back and learned all the songs and dances. And then who was it? I was thrown out. And Jane Powell.
Powell.
In all the pictures we were in together, it's fine. We were in all those very peculiar pictures. We were in together until now. Yeah, and it's your first line, baby.
Yeah, that's right. My first line. Just imagine that he loves me dearly. Just imagine I am his sincerely. I love you.
day is closing. On his knees there, I hear him proposing. He's not present, still is present to just imagine that.
Just delightful.
Oh, thank you very much.
Really? Very charming.
That's very nice of you, Steve. Thank you.
No, I really mean it. That was one of the best commercials I ever saw.
Why don't we talk about your Broadway show? You know, Steve is going to star in the Broadway musical version of What Makes Sammy Run. Right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
I think that the part of Sammy Glick is one of the meanest roles an actor ever had to play.
Yeah, you're sort of a nice, easygoing fellow. How do you get so mean?
Well, I'm working on it. You know, I've already started to get into character.
What do you do?
Well, when I get up in the morning, I kick a cat.
Yeah.
That's the first thing I do. Then I have lunch with Jackie Leonard, Don Rickles.
Boy.
Then I have dinner with Oscar Levant.
Yeah.
And I found a laundry that ruins my shirts. And it gets me furious. We bought a washing machine that leaks. You know, all those things.
These things make you mean? Make you really mean?
Well, if they don't, then I go for the big blockbuster.
What's that?
Edie's mother comes over for 2 weeks.
Oh, boy, I bet that really does it.
Just thinking about it makes me furious. See how I'm shaking already? Why is she... Oh, see, I'm sorry. See, that meanness is coming out of me. I said, no, don't touch me. Watch it. I'm starting to get mean already. See that? I'm starting to steam. I'm getting mad. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
are we friends, Judy?
Yeah,
I mean, do you love me?
I do.
You really love me?
Yes.
And do me a favor, will you?
Sure.
Just let me wrap you in a mouth. Once. Come on, not you. You're a friend of mine. I got to get rid of this hostility. Look what you built me up to. Somebody, I got to wrap some. How about somebody in the audience? Somebody, don't hold me back. Let me alone. Somebody in the audience. Want to wrap in a mouth? How about that? I'll tell you what. I'm willing to pay for it. $50. Somebody, come on. Come on. I'll tell you what, I'll run a sale. 2 for $75. Anybody? How about that little old lady with the gray hair? Come on, huh? Come on. I'm right in the glasses. Come on. Come on up here. Right, no, but no volunteers, huh? It's going to have to be you, baby.
Why don't you sing it off?
Sing what?
Sing your rage off.
Sing my rage off?
Yes.
All right. Give me a G flat there. I never mind. Just give me a G. I'll flatten it myself. You better give me it again. Give it to me again. I'm in a mood for love.
Oh, stop! That's all right. Don't stop in my life. Get your own show for him.
Yeah. I'm in a mood for love.
What's the matter, Archie? Matter anymore? You're coming down a little bit there.
Heaven was in your eyes.
Not that calm, not that.
Bright as the stars. I'm hooked on you.
Yeah.
You're under.
Oh, is it I like anyone? That. Edie's mother.
Lovely lady.
A leaky washing machine.
Nobody's perfect.
Linda.
I'm in the mood for love. Oh, you know, I feel much better now.
Really?
I feel much better.
Oh, you don't look very good.
I do the same thing, you know, when I get mad.
You sing it off?
No, I wrap somebody in the mouth.
Okay, gang, here it is. Here it is, the film medley. There's a piece of film for you, and here you are, Judy, belt it out there, and here's one for you. Sing it. There we go. Oh, just think, Judy Garland and June Allyson together. Again.
Yeah.
Gee, those wonderful MGM musicals, huh? The memories and the tears.
You mean you really cried for us?
No, my folks did. I don't remember either one of them. Go get them for good old MGM.
I don't.
We'll be right back.
love with you, honey. Say what you say. No one else will do, honey. Seems funny, but it's true. Loved you from the start, honey. Bless your little heart, honey. Every day would be so sunny, honey, with you.
Beside the Nile, a famous queen there dwelt. Her clothes were few but full of style, her figure slim and svelte. On every man that wandered by,
she pulled a fleet of barra eye.
And everyone observed with awe that her work was swift, but never brought. Like Leo Patterer, if I could have my way. Each man she met, she went and kissed his dozens on her waiting list. Mark Antony admitted that what first made her skin was a wibbly wobbly wibbly dance that Leo Patterer did.
New dances now and then that kind of made them blush.
Each time she did them, scores of men got injured in the rush.
They'd stand there gaping in a line
and watch her agitate her spine.
It simply used to knock them flat when she went like this
and then like that.
I'd be like Frank.
Better
was always on the spot. She gave those poor Egyptians links and
yes, so much.
Mark Antony admitted that what first made him skid was a wibbly, wobbly, wibbly, wobbly, wibbly dance that Cleopatra did. Roar!
Thou sweet, thou grand, wouldst kiss me pretty, would hold my hand. Both thine eyes are cute too, what they do to me. Hear me holla, I choose a sweet Lollapalooza in thee. I'd feel so rich in a hut or two, two rooms and kitchen, I'm sure would do. Give me just a lot of, not a plot of land. Land, thou swell, thou witty, thou sweet, thou grand. Thou swell, thou witty, thou grand.
Remember, somewhere the sun is shining, and so the right thing to do is make it shine for you, a heart full of joy and gladness. Will always banish sadness and strife. So always look for the silver lining and try to find the sunny side of
comes a bitter pack, and I'd like to be safe in bed. Skies are weeping while the world is sleeping, trouble heaping on our heads. It is vain to remain and chatter and to wait for a clearer sky. Helter skelter, I must fly for shelter till the clouds roll by. Look for the silver lining when I'd
like to be safe in bed. Remember,
skies are weeping while the world is shining. So the only thing try to make it shine just a little bit brighter.
The cares are gonna be lighter
when your heart's full of joy and gladness. Then you will find your place in the sun.
So keep on looking for that bluebird and listening for his song.
Your days will all be shining
when you find that silver lining. You never can go wrong.
I was born at the Princess Theater.
I'm gonna look through this thing for once. That's it. Oh, this brings back a lot of memories, yes. Let's see what we have. And this drawer is always locked. Locked. I'm gonna get it open one of these days. I don't know what's in there. I think it's either a munchkin or somebody with an old subpoena. here we are. This is bringing back memories. Now, this reminds me of Louis B. Mayer. This wasn't his. I don't mean that. It just reminds me of a story about Louis B. Mayer, that, you know, he was the head of MGM Studios, and he always wanted to create, and he had to handle all of the stockbrokers and all the boards of directors and so forth, and he was longing to just create something. And I used to have to go to his office all the time, once a day, to fight or something. Never got very far, He used to relate this story to me. Each time I went to his, I was there for 16 years. And he would tell me about the time he went to visit the set of Naughty Marietta with a leading lady and a leading man who didn't like each other very much. They didn't like each other at all. But they had to sing with each other. Now, singing leading ladies and leading men is something else, because you have to sing that close and nobody looks too attractive. You can see your occlusion all over there. Louis Mayer came on that set of Naughty Marietta, and the leading lady who wore this wig, not Louis Mayer, was supposed to be singing Ah, Sweet Mystery of Life, leaving Nelsonetti, you know who it is. Jeanette was climbing a flight of steps, and she couldn't have cared less about leaving Nelson. And it was the end of the picture. She was supposed to be heartbroken, and she just walked up the steps and sang, Ah, Sweet Mystery of Life. And I said, Oh, I know, at last. Louis Mayer came in with a lot of stockbrokers and things, and he saw his moment to add artistry. So he whipped off her wig
and put it on himself and climbed up the stairs and said, "You're not doing it. Let me tell you a little lady how to do it." And he climbed up the hole and sang "Our Sweet Mystery of Life" and cried. Steel tears. He was so proud of that. He was so proud that he had contributed to that, that whenever I'd go to his office to say, "Now, wait a minute, Mr. Mayor, you can't let me do four pictures at once. You know, I'm in the wrong car." He said, "Did I ever tell you about the time I went to visit a set of Naughty Marietta?" And he'd get up from behind this enormous desk and walk up an imaginary flight of stairs and sing all 32 bars of "Our Sweet Mystery of Life." And he would wait every time. And I let him go through 32 bars, and I'd always say, "Marvelous, Mr. Mayor." Gee, I have no character at all, see. I never said, I heard it before, Louis. Anyway, that's what reminded me. What about a song cue? Do you think that's obvious enough? I never will forget. My goodness, hey, just to think of her, it gives my heart a pang. I never will forget how that brave Jeanette just stood there in the ruins and sang. San Francisco. Here is your wonder. Saying I wonder no more. Other places only make me love you best. Tell me you're the one in all the golden world. San Francisco, I'm coming home again. Never to roam again. Never to roam again. San Francisco. Right when I arrive, I really come alive. And you will laugh to see me. To watch it get dark from the top of the mark. There's Brooklyn Bridge, London Bridge, and the Bridge of San Luis Rey. But the only bridge that's a real gone bridge is a bridge across the bay.
Come back to you.
The second half of the Judy Garland Show has been brought to you by General Mills, home of Betty Crocker products, new Gold Medal Wonder Flour, and the Big G Goodness Cereal.